Got this, Excellency, the High Commissioner of India. Your Excellency, welcome. Thanks for finding time.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to be with you.
It's been a fantastic, it's like a revelation to me actually when you spoke about Ganga, Jamuna and the confluence. And there are so many other Indian festivals, like for example Paramasala in Sydney, that is happening. How do you combine all that? For example, in Melbourne there may be some festivals happening. How do you combine it with and present one single India festival?
It can't be done, and nor should it be attempted. Mm-hmm. I think those festivals that the Indian community in Melbourne, in Sydney, in Brisbane, in Perth organizes, they should continue to organize those. We encourage them, we participate in them. I personally try to go to many of them, as do our Consul Generals. But what we are trying to bring in Confluence of India is something different. We are trying to showcase a talent from India. We are trying to showcase India's diversity, and we are trying to showcase excellence. For us, the festival is a step towards promoting Brand India in Australia. And Brand India means we look at different facets of it. Culture, arts, creativity, talent, a whole lot of different areas. So. I don't think it would be right for us to say that we should enter into a space that the Indian community in Australia is already doing great work in. For us, we are trying to bring something directly from India, and that has a space of its own.
Mm-hmm. When you have so many talented people coming and giving us these fantastic shows here, would you be happy to organize some workshop, especially for the younger generation, younger people of not just Indian origin, but those who are interested in Indian culture?
Workshops are an integral part of the festival's program. So for example, the people who, the director of Pia Behrupia is going to be doing a workshop with Adakar Theatre Group over here. Kalakshetra have already committed to doing workshops, for example, at Monash University's School of Music and Dance. So these are a part of the program. Wherever we see that there's a slot available, we are in touch both with Indian community organizations and also with Australian right. schools of music and dance yeah. to see where we can collaborate.
Right. And of course, we always talk about the commonalities between Australia and India, starting from cricket to culture and everything. But it hasn't really translated into commercial success as compared to, for example, the commercial links between China and Australia as a comparison. Do you think that these kinds of events will promote that commercial output which is lacking between Australia and India?
I think those are intangible objectives. Festivals are known to promote tourism, and there is a fairly direct link between culture and tourism. Commerce is the next level, and I think understanding each other, familiarity with each other does produce different outcomes. But I think when we talk about trade and investment relations, you should recognize that China is the largest trading partner for half the world, including with India. And from our point of view, our exports to Australia have grown steadily. We have a number of Indian companies coming here, establishing operations there. We now see a growing trend of Australian companies enter Indian market. And that's something that we want to encourage. We look at Australia as a country with serious expertise in several key areas, and that's something, whether it's in education and skills, whether it is in services, it's in smart cities, that's something that we want to try and leverage.
Now you have shown the way. Would you be using your good offices to encourage the Australian government to put on an Australian cultural show in Indian cities?
I'm sure that would be on their horizon, on their agenda. This evening you saw we had senior representatives from the Department of Arts in the Australian government. We had senior representatives from the Department of Foreign Affairs. Today, the world understands the importance of cultural diplomacy. It recognizes the importance of public diplomacy. And, you know, it's a question that you would be best posing to my Australian friends.
Yes, of course. If there is one final message you want to send out to our viewers, what would that be, High Commissioner?
Well, today we have presented to you the diversity of India, the festival that we are bringing, the multitude of components that we have in terms of music and theater and visual arts and dance and everything else. We hope that we spread the message that it is a unique opportunity for Australians, for Indian Australian community, to come and really savor the best of India.
Excellency, thanks for talking to us.
Thank you very much.